Hey everyone, Mark from My Size Hedge Fund here, and we are back with some Netrunner playing HB Architects of Tomorrow. It wasn't a deck I had planned to play initially, but then I saw it was called Snowfort and clicked into it, and there was a Calvin and Hobbes comic, so I was instantly sold on it. We're going to mulligan this hand, but basically it plays a lot of Byroids, a lot of good stuff, and hopefully we can get the economy going as well. Okay, so not quite what we wanted. Fairchild on HQ should keep Steve a little quiet. We'll put the Ravana on Orndy and take a credit. At least that way we can get the 2-for-1 as well if they decide to run. No, they're running Ravana first. Okay, that makes sense. So they're going to go for the poke, not overly commit to HQ accesses. Okay. So Seder is a great remote ice. We'll draw once though, looking for some money. DBS is pretty good as well. We don't need it in our scoring remote, I don't think. So we'll just stick it out to the side. Anyway, while some of this is ongoing, I am going to Euros, which is this week because of when I'll be uploading this video. Oh, bang job. So if you do see me, come say hello. Unlike Worlds, I've been using the face cam a little bit, so hopefully it won't be the sound of my dulcet voice that you rely on to find me, but you'll see me around and say hey. Always good to meet people who watch the channel and just chat Netrunner and general day-to-day stuff. So yeah, looking forward to Euros. I am not entirely prepared, maybe not as much as I would have liked, but quietly confident. We'll see. Unfortunately, the qualifying restriction for day two is quite tough, I think. So we'll see. It should be good fun anyway. I do enjoy the tournament scene and all that goes with it. So they're going to get in. It's going to be either, oh yeah, we got two res Ravana for free. And we'll give them back a bank job because it's the harder one to play. We can actually play around it a little bit. Choose a card to remove from the game, we'll get rid of Gamble, give them the bank job. And now they have two extra cards that they have to bin as well, so that works out okay for us. Kalera and On the Lamb. Well, there's some money for us at least. Okay, so now we can look at getting a Vitruvius in. Oh, no, we can't, we had it robbed while I was chatting away about other things. So the 1 in 5 pick worked out perfectly for them. Hopefully I pay more attention than this at Euros. But thankfully I won't have to talk at the same time as playing, which makes a difference. That, or I can chat away to my opponent and tell them exactly what's in my hand. So they're going for R&D. We don't have any more Byroids on the table, unfortunately. But we can get Ravana on the scoring server. We don't need the preemptive, so I think just get this over here and get this ticking away. We have enough to res both. Plus they only have 3 clicks, so they might be a little less willing to just go nuts and run. This Fairchild really hurts. Oh, in fact we're gonna get a free res over here. Okay, this works out well for me. So we can end the run here. We can do a force them to pay 3. Let's go with pay 3. No. Because money is good to always hit. So we get another Fairchild. But we don't need it really. I think we draw credit and use this again. So we will need to get something else here because at the moment they can just run through and lock us with a turning wheel. Architect is a good pick as well. Goodish. We have to remember that they have bank job in hand, so DPS isn't a great install. So maybe we do Fairchild 2 instead. Namakua. Interesting. Okay, time to get everything iced up then. Now we can go Fairchild, Fairchild. Click. At least then we have the Bioroids to spare. And now if we can find an agenda, we are all good to go. Shipping for 10 as well means that we get even better value. But we just have to find the agendas first. Alrighty. Oh, perfect. This has appeared. So, gain 4. Get this down. Shipment from 10 in. Otherwise, it's 4 credits. I think we just hedge fund and score it out the hard way. Although, we might not get too many of these chances either. No, I think we're okay. Okay, so we're on the board. Drug dealer is hurting them. And the fact that we gave them bank job instead is also really good. So now, which one do we want to fire? Pain 2? Oh, okay. Drug dealer's gone. And we'll raise the other Fairchild. So it's going to be costly to power this up. And even at that, then, it's still going to be, you know, it's not going to be cheap to get through. Snow Fort in action. And the Fairchild is really hurting Steve's ability. Although, the heap at the moment isn't that tempting. They've been unlucky with draws, perhaps. So, slam this in, get the win scored ability of this. Not finding any of our economy yet. Wouldn't mind finding a Maryland campaign or anything at all would be good. Thankfully, so corporate sales team and even our ability is doing well. I mean, we've gotten 3 pieces of ice for free. Now, unfortunately, most of it can be clicked through, but them's the break sometimes. And that is the trade-off you play. And that is the unfortunate thing about Architects Tomorrow is some of these aren't that dangerous when the runner just doesn't care enough. And they will be perfectly willing to just go for it. Information sifting. Yeah, this probably isn't the matchup for it. That's going to be good for us as well. For the moment, let's just get this scored. And now we're covered for the rest of the game. Hopefully it won't go on long enough that we get 15 ticks of this, but at least we're getting plenty of money coming in over time. Drug dealers back down. They're back on the drugs. Install shipment advance. Might as well just try and burn through this game. And hopefully keeps them away from HQ as well. Of course, unfortunately, this now is a dead agenda for us. Because scoring does nothing. Okay, so there's the restricted card. Some bits and pieces. So their economy engine may be finally coming online. But even at that, they have some work to do. So install, advance. bring us down to 6. So I think for the moment we just chill, draw once. Eli, not essential. Of course, there could be a surprise Maxwell James or Dean Lister in there somewhere, and that always hurts. So Eli is the better choice, just because it actually stops. Ravana then can be used to end the run as well, and Seder, of course, will just become more powerful. Sneak Door comes down. Even if they hit it, it's not too bad. They might use the Turning Wheel here. But this install pushes them one step further from being able to contest here if we get lucky or a good draw. And yeah, because that install, they were short on money as well. So, okay, we're just going to find all of these. So let's go for this, install that, that, and go for that. Now, if we can't stop them here, we've left ourselves a little short. We have 9, so we have enough to res both. But we'll be short on this score, unfortunately. So maybe patience being a virtue there, should have just waited one more turn. But at least we're putting some pressure on. We might force them into overcommitting. Maybe if we just have to res Eli, it's not too bad. Sneak Door here will get some points anyway, more than likely. Run on R&D. They don't actually need any of these if they go for a Hail Mary. Turning Wheel is probably the keeper. Ah, so Abinail comes down. And they are going to break, which is super expensive, as opposed to going for something, the bypass ability. And now we just have to hope that, well, we should be okay. We'll give them, okay. Yeah, that we got a good setup. We didn't have much of the economy that we wanted. If we look at our deck here, we can see that Marilyn campaigns were shoved right together and Adonis right at the end. So, you know, a lot of our good stuff was late to the party. Hedge Fund at the bottom is never what you want to see. Adonis's corporate sales teams even. So, economy was a little light. Corporate sales team did some work. The Bifrost Array, you know, topped it up. We got one extra tick off it, so not super, but did some work. And yeah, the CFC is an interesting one. Would have gotten us some money here. The free rise here was very, very important. I think if they challenged here, if they'd had the breaker, or if they'd kept the Abingdale for running here, they would click through the end the runs, let the draw fire. You can bypass if you're going all in. Seder, it would have stopped them, but at least it costs us time and money. But yeah, so that worked out well. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you very much for watching. And if you are at Euros, come say hello. Best of luck in the tournament. If I don't meet you, if I meet you face to face in the tournament itself, go easy on me. And yeah, back soon with another video.